Hi guys, welcome back to Wong Chemistry Channel. For this video, we are going to discuss the weaknesses of Bohr postulate. And there are two weaknesses of Bohr postulate that we are going to look into today. Just a kind reminder over here, Niels Bohr proposed four postulate. The first one, the electron will move in a circular orbit around the nucleus. That is the first postulate proposed by Bohr. The second, in the permitted orbit, the energy of the electron motion is quantized. So every electron in a certain energy level having a fixed amount of energy. The third postulate proposed by Niels Bohr is about the energy. There will be no energy absorbed or released when the electron remain at ground state. And last but not least, the energy will be emitted or absorbed by an electron when it transits from one energy level to another. We have talked about these four postulates in previous videos. And there is one video that I discussed in detail about all these postulates. But there are some weaknesses in these four postulates. So, what are the weaknesses of the Bohr postulates? There are two weaknesses. The first one is proposed by D. Broglie postulate. The second weaknesses is proposed by Heisenberg uncertainty principle. And we will go through one by one. D. Broglie postulate. What D. Broglie stated is the particles such as electron possess dual nature. The dual nature is the wave and the particle's property. Because in Bohr atomic model, Bohr proposed that electron is a particle. So when electron is a particle, the electron must have both of the dual nature of a particle, which is wave and also particle's property. And the formula that the de Broglie used to prove this postulate is as given. But we are not going to do any calculations, so don't worry so much about the formula, okay? We are going to understand the postulate only. So, as I said just now, in the Bohr atomic postulate, we agree on the electron is a particle. So, when the electron is a particle, it must have the dual nature properties. And the dual nature properties is wave and particle's property. And what D. Broglie trying to explain over here is when the electron possess a wave-like property, when the electron as a particle having the wave-like property, then it should diffuse like a wave into a dimensionless space. So when the electron is a particle, the electron must have the dual nature property. And when the dual nature property is involved, the wave property, then the electron should behave like the wave and having the wave-like property. And the wave-like property is include diffuse into dimensionless space. But in the Bohr atomic model, the Bohr atomic model stated that the electron is located in a specific and fixed energy level. So how can the electron be in this specific energy level when the electron should behave like the wave and move into the dimensionless space, right? Therefore, the weaknesses in the Bohr postulate that pointed out by the D. Broglie over here, saying that the electron should not be confined into a particular energy level. Like I say, if the electron behave like a wave and move into dimensionless space, then the electron cannot be sitting on a specific energy level. So this is one of the weaknesses in the Bohr postulate, alright? Next, the second weaknesses of Bohr postulate is proposed by Heisenberg uncertainty principle. So what is Heisenberg trying to say? Heisenberg stated that it's impossible to know simultaneously at the same time. Alright, it's impossible to know at the same time both of the momentum and also the position of a particle with certainty. I'm going to explain this statement later on, don't worry. And the formula that used by Heisenberg uncertainty principle is as given. Again, there will be no calculation, so don't worry so much about the formula. The formula is for reference only. Okay, so Heisenberg stated that just now, impossible. It is impossible to know simultaneously the momentum and the position certainty. Okay, very simple example over here. If you are moving, can you tell me your exact position while you are moving? If the ball is rolling, all right, the ball is rolling down a hill. And can I know exactly where is the ball when the ball is rolling? When your dad is driving on the road, can I know the position of your dad exactly the same time when your dad is actually moving on the road? Okay? It's impossible because the thing is still moving. How do I know the exact position? We will never know the exact position when the thing is still moving. But if you remember, what Bohr proposed in the Bohr postulate is, I have N equals to 1 over here, energy level 1. I have electron in the energy level 1. And then I have N equals to 2 over here. And Bohr stated that we have electron at the specific energy level, and we know where the electron is. But at the same time, Bohr also stated that electron will circular around the nucleus in a specific orbit, right? So you say that the electron is keep moving. The electron keeps circular around the nucleus. But at the same time, you're saying that you know where is the electron. N equals to 1 or N equals to 2. So what Heisenberg uncertainty trying to prove over here is, how can you know simultaneously at the same time the movement and also the position of electron? You are saying that the electron move around the nucleus, means the electron will keep moving. But at the same time, you know where is the electron. How do you know the position of the electron when the electron is actually keep moving? Therefore, the second weaknesses in your Bohr atomic postulate is the electron should not be confined in a particular orbit, and its exact position and velocity cannot be determined. So we cannot say that the electron is actually in a particular orbit specifically, and we cannot identify the exact position and the velocity at the same time. Okay? And that is the weaknesses that pointed out by the Heisenberg uncertainty principle in the Bohr postulate. And therefore, we can only determine the probability of finding an electron. Probability of finding an electron is possible. We can roughly know where is the electron, but we won't know the exact position of the electron when the electron is actually keep moving around the nucleus. Alright? So, this is the two postulate and principle that pointed out the weaknesses in Bohr postulate. So make sure you know what the Broglie postulate talk about, and also Heisenberg uncertainty principle pointed out. Okay? Thank you for watching this short video. Make sure you like the video and subscribe my channel. If you have any question, drop it in the comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.